Hello everyone. I hope you all are well and safe. So today I am going to explain a new project. So this project demonstrates the use of two push buttons to operate two different LEDs. So this is the schematic of this project. And these are the components required for this project. So we need one Arduino Uno, one mini breadboard, two LED, two push button, four resistors, and some jumper wires. So this is the design I have already made. You can see from here I have already designed the circuit. So I will explain through it, and I also explain the role of each component in this project. So you can see from here I have used two different LED, two push buttons. So first of all, I will tell you the construction of push button. You can see from here there are four points. Okay, so these two points, you can see from here, terminal 1B and terminal 1A. These two terminals are connected to each other, and these are connected in series, same as terminal 2B and terminal 2A are connected in series. So this is the internal feature of push button. So now I will explain how I. So you can see from here, ground and the terminal, signal terminal, we connected with each other. You can see from here, I have connected terminal A to ground and terminal 1B to signal. And another terminal will direct connected to the power, that is 5 volt. Okay. So this is the connection of push button, and LED connection is very easy. And I have already told you, one terminal will be connected to ground and another will be connected to signal. So this is the connection of LED and push button. So now I will see you my code. So you can see from here I have two push button. Yeah, so you can see from here I have two push buttons. So I defined two buttons, button 1 equal to 0 and button 2 equal to 0. After that I wrote setup function. So in the setup function I set the pin 2 and pin 3 as output, and pin 8 and pin 9 as input. After that, I write a void loop. So in the loop function, initially I read the value of the value of 8 and read the value of 9. That is input function. That value will be given by the push button. Like when we press the push button, then button 1 will read the mode of push button. Like it will read push button is high or low. So you can see from here I have defined button 1 equal to digital read 8, means button 1 read the mode of push button connected to 8, and button 2 will read the mode of push button connected to 9. After that I have used the if condition. So if function, the Arduino makes some decision. So if the button is, you can see from here, if button 1 is equal to high, it means if the button is pressed and this button check the state, like push button is high, then digital pin connected to 2, the LED connected to pin 2, that is the orange one, will glow. Otherwise that will become low. After that I also use another if condition, like if button 2 is equal to high, then LED connected to pin 3 will be glow. Otherwise both LED will not glow. So in this project you can see, if I press the button connected to 8, then LED 2 will glow, and if the push button connected to 9, then LED connected to 3 will glow. So now I will simulate this circuit so you can easily understand this. So you can see from here my simulation has done. Now I will press the button. So now I will press the button connected to 8. So you can see from here, when I press the button, this LED has glow, and when I leave the button, then LED get off. Similarly, when I press the push button connected to 9, then green LED will glow. That is, when I remove the button from push button, then you can see from here, green LED connected to pin 3 has become low. So this is the project. I think you will understand. Yes. So you can see from here, this is the whole project. This project basically explains two LEDs connected to two different push button. When one push button will be pressed, then one LED will glow, and when second push button will pressed, then second LED will glow. So this is the whole project, and I hope you will understand this. And I think you should simulate this circuit, design this circuit, and simulate in hardware. Thank you.